Beautiful. 8 1/4. See ya. Yep, that clicker is getting a workout today. Rudy, I think I'll follow your example today and I'll put these nice big bluegill back too. With our super duper ultra lightweight fish finder mounting system today, showing us exactly the depth and temperature of the water, I think it's time that we put on a slip bobber. So let's get down there and get filly. Hey Rudy, what are your thoughts on using a slip bobber? Do you know what they are?
Yeah, I know what they are. They're good for, you know, cold water and stuff. But I think you can catch fish year round.
Okay, so does that mean yes, I should use it?
Well, yeah, silly, get out there and do it. Don't be a silly little boy.
Good advice, Rude. I'll give it a try. Yeah, slip bobbers. Okay, this flat over here is typically loaded with fish. Of course, that's a weed line over there. And as the weeds progress, which is good, get out a little bit. I mean, this thing can become loaded, and by the fall, it's just fantastic. See if we can catch a few filly fish by getting funky with them. Got a little closer to the weeds. So now over here in 8 feet. And since this slip bobber set for about 4, this one grabbed it right on the edge of the weeds. Woo! Precision capture. Look at that filly boy, Sparky. Pretty cool, huh? Wow, I'm putting back some really nice fish today. See ya. And the question might be, can I see the fish that I'm gonna fish for? Sometimes you don't know really, but at that distance, you don't know exactly what's between the transducer and where it hits the water, but yeah, you can see them in the hydril and stuff. Let's see what our slippy bobber can snatch out of there. Whoa! Yes, sir. Whoopee! Pitching a slip bobber along the bluff is lots of fun too. Pitch it over there and all of a sudden it's out there underwater. Alright, did you grab a garden worm? Yes, you did. This fish says, I cannot resist a funky garden worm. I'm with you. I'm on your side. I can't resist them either. See ya. If I find a fishy looking spot, I usually let the slippy thing take a shot at them. And many times there's both bass and bluegill along the banks. What do we got here? Oh, this might be a greenie. Nope, it's just a big bluegill. Just, yeah. Like I'm really disappointed with a bluegill like that. No, I'm not. It's a nice one, very pretty. And you got funkified. I'm just like you, I've only got so much time, so much gas money, and therefore bear paws garden worms. I do not leave home without them. Bye. Don't mess around. Just get them by the hundreds. You'll be happy. Okay, without your fish finder, you're not going to know how deep you are, but with a fish finder, you can just look at it and go, oh my gosh, I didn't know I was in 10 or 12 feet of water, and I certainly didn't know that stuff was down there. So you can make some strategic decisions, and that's why I really love these underwater eyes. No, it's not forward-facing sonar, but it sure does help you unlock the secrets of the depths, that's for sure. There's some tasty looking structure down below me here. Yep, that kind of stuff is going to hold these kind of fish. See ya. Sparky, do not besmirch my slop bubbler. I like it. Stop showing off. There you go. Oh! You're just trying to rip my thumb up, aren't you, Bubba? It's not a huge fish, but boy, that last head shake was a dandy. And this is a fat little bass. My goodness. Beautiful. Lorraine, you like these little nuisances? These are really fighters. See ya. Getting funky is really hard to beat. That's a good jumper. Isn't that funny? Afternoon bass just turn on almost like their alarm clock goes off. Main depth that I had good luck with was about 4.5 or 5 feet deep. And I put it right over on near the bank. And typically I'd stay out in 10, 12, 13 feet. If it hit the bottom, I just kind of jiggle it out to where the cork stood up straight. And if there's a fish over there, I just jumped on it. All right, well, I guess your name is Clickbait. Bye-bye. I think this particular body of water is ready for me to put away the medium lights and ultralights and drag out the mediums and medium heavies and bring down some power plastics, because these guys are just sitting over there saying, give me something to eat, would you please? These snacks are okay, and I know you like to catch them because they're fun. But we will hit those big old worms and stuff. I think it's ready. So in the not too far future, we'll be back with some Texas rigs and looking for your mom. See ya. Okay, the bobber stop rig worked really good, I thought. All things considering, a lot of times they don't want something just sitting in front of them. They want it moving or so they can chase it. Today, if I gave it a little jiggle or they were in the neighborhood and I dropped it in and on their head, they did grab it. So it was a lot of fun to use. It's supposed to be mainly a cold weather, you know, deep crappie type thing. Might try it later on this winter. But for a summertime fish getter, it did pretty good. And to close out the show, I have to thank fishfindermouse.com for their outstanding ingenuity in putting that 30 amp hour lithium ion battery. That thing's worked all day long, no problems whatsoever with this smaller Humminbird fish finder. Works great, and it's light. Between the bass and the bluegill, I put my hands on 42 fish. And therefore, all I can say is, I'm glad you came along. Thanks for watching, and from our house to your house, God bless.